Hallihallo, meine Lieben, und herzlich willkommen zurück zu The Council. Wir sind hier stehen geblieben, und zwar habe ich recht, Monsieur de Richet, oder können Sie irgendwas mit diesem Vorschlag anfangen? Da ist Immunität, Schutz vor den Amerikanern.
If I were you, Senor Godoy, I would think twice before stirring up a scandal.
I beg your pardon?
Given the size of your colonies, you won't be able to keep them for long. A number of countries are eyeing them as we speak. The United States would have no trouble taking them. For all intents and purposes, you have no army in place. By wanting to keep everything, you risk losing it all, especially your colonies in South America, which are far more valuable to you.
That is indeed the danger, Duke Manuel. If it comes to war over Louisiana, you will lose, and probably a good deal more than you now imagine.
Young man, you are indeed a dark horse, aren't you?
I must say, William, I find your project mostly disfavors me. I thought you were my friend.
And I am, Mr. President. That is why I'm doing everything in my power to calm your expansionist fervor. France, in Louisiana, should persuade you not to attempt anything to take the territory by force. Louisiana is a vast wetland where you would needlessly lose most of your troops. It would weaken you and offer certain nations the perfect opportunity to take back your famous United States. I am protecting you from yourself, George. Trust me.
I understand. But with friends like you, sir, I certainly don't need any more enemies. I hope you know what you're doing.
Oh.
Am I imagining things, or does it look like Washington isn't aware of Mortimer's plan?
Not to put too fine a point on it, Lord Mortimer, but I doubt the Holy See would be in favor of Catholic Louisiana being handed over to secular revolutionaries and king killers.
I should think Monsieur de Richet has an opinion on this subject, does he not?
Ach mein Gott, in Frankreich wird die Christen beschützen. Oh Gott. Frankreich kann die päpstliche Meinung egal sein. Mortimers Welt. Da hat er Immunität. Mortimers Weltkarten in Erinnerung rufen. Mortimers Weltkarten in Erinnerung? Nein. Frankreich kann die päpstliche Meinung egal sein.
If France took the papal states, their opinion over the sale of Louisiana would be definitely resolved.
Good Lord. You are talking of an invasion of Italy.
Don't take it the wrong way, Your Eminence. Colonization brings with it many benefits. You'll see.
Very funny, Monsieur de Richet.
Scheiße.
Mi auguro che insegnerete l'educazione a questo giovanotto presuntuoso, Sir Gregory.
Wir müssen jetzt hier nicht Italienisch sprechen, ne? Das war doch Italienisch, ne? War nicht Latein, oder?
I hope that you will teach this pretentious young man some manners, Sir Gregory.
Mm-hmm.
It looks like I won't be just making friends here.
In any case, my lord, I doubt the English crown will agree.
Ich will sicher Ihnen, Emily, nie Preußen für diese Vereinbarung akzeptieren.
I assure you, Emily, the Prussian will never accept this agreement. Volner looks like he's set on ruining Mortimer's plan.
Duchess, I am persuaded that we shall find a common ground.
That's enough, William. These are grave times. We don't care about the fate of Louisiana. That worthless expanse of putrid swamps interests no one but yourself.
Speak for yourself, my friend.
Hold on there, Mr. Royal Gigolo. Lower the volume and let Sir Gregory finish.
Home, Godoy, and now Volner? Mortimer's adversaries are ready to tear each other to pieces, and he takes a malicious pleasure in watching it happen.
How dare you!
Gentlemen, let us try to remain calm.
There you are, William. See where your projects have taken us, as per usual. Chaos! That's enough. I'm tired. We shall continue this discussion tomorrow, but please be aware that your project will never be ratified. Those who are opposed to this project, follow me. Are you coming with us, Monsieur de Riche?
Just...
Come, Gregory. I think Louis would rather stay. Wouldn't you, Louis?
Scheiße. Bleiben und Mortimer unterstützen, mitgehen und Home unterstützen. Scheiße, ich weiß nicht. Louisiana nicht sowieso von... Hä? Das ist jetzt kacke. Ich könnte von denen hier mehr erfahren, auf Dauer, als nur von ihm. Also gehe ich mit und unterstütze Home.
At the risk of displeasing you, my lord, I'd rather follow Sir Gregory. I don't think this is a place for the order.
Louis? No. Let him go, Mr. President. Everyone is free to choose.
Der Präsident war ja auch noch da. Aber der lässt sich zu sehr in die Tasche reden, ne?
How can he be so blind? If he keeps this up, he'll lead our countries to their destruction.
Don't worry, we shall counter him, Sir Gregory.
We have to act immediately.
Calm down, Gregory. We only have to vote against his project, and that's it.
They haven't got a chance. Just one vote will suffice.
True. There is no chance of a unanimous vote. And he knows it. He must be preparing something else. What is he plotting?
Komm, wir spielen mal böse.
I know about his plan.
What did you just say, Louis?
His aim is for the United States to take the whole of the North American continent.
But that is impossible!
A democratic superpower.
I don't understand. That has nothing to do with the coming vote.
You will ask for France to take over Louisiana, and then hand it over to the United States, and so double the size of their territory.
Once that's done, he will just need to push a bit more, and you will lose North America, Duke Manuel.
God's blood! Has he gone mad?
No, Johann. He has always been mad. Louis, I would like to thank you for what you've just revealed. If not for you, I don't know if we'd have been capable of deciphering his plans quickly enough to be able to counter him.
What are we going to do now that we know about it?
Destroy him.
No! We'll beat him at his own game, my friends. His plan begins with Louisiana, which is still yours, Duke Manuel. He will begin with you. Expect to receive an envoy, French most probably. He will try to convince you by every possible means. Whatever he says, whatever he promises, you have just one response. It's war. If war is what you want, war is what you'll get. And on your own territory, in your homes. Enough games. Spain will join the coalition against France and declare war. You too, Duchess Hillsborough. You will speak to the Queen so that Great Britain commits to going to war with France.
What do you expect from the Papal States, Sir Gregory?
What do you think? That they hold a mass? They will go to war, of course. What is it that you didn't understand in what I just told you? We all declare war on France. Militarily, politically, and financially.
Habe ich gerade dafür gesorgt, dass alle Frankreich den Krieg erklären?
And me, Sir Greg, how can I help?
Louis, you have won my trust. The order will have to act in France, but even before that, I'm going to need you. Right here and right now. Leave me now. I have to prepare for tomorrow. Let's meet early tomorrow morning for the next phase of the conference, which promises to be most exciting. Louis,
I'd like to see you a moment, please.
Ich muss ganz ehrlich sagen, ich hatte hier diesen...
Thank you for signing with me today. I won't forget it. I'm going to need you. Help me counter Mortimer on his own ground. Right here. I'm sure he'll try and win some of you over. He needs our votes. Now, you leave that to me. In the meantime, I must ask you to go and see President Washington and persuade him to trust me and join us.
I'll do my best.
You should go right away. There's no time to lose. William already has a head start on us.
Very well. I'll go right away.
Ich habe ihn hier, den mit den Geschminkten da, den habe ich, also Home habe ich ganz falsch eingeschätzt bis jetzt. Wo muss ich denn jetzt hin?
Let me in, please.
Oh, I'm sorry, sir, but that's impossible.
I'm looking for President Washington. Would you know where he is by any chance?
Unfortunately not, sir. All I can say to sir is that the president is no longer in the conference room.
All right. I'll go looking for him myself. Come now. There's nothing secret going on in there. Let me in.
Oh, I am sorry, but I cannot say, sir. I am to follow Lord Mortimer's instructions.
Can you at least tell me who is still in the room? I'm looking for a guest.
Of course, sir. It would seem that only Lord Mortimer and Mr. Napoleon are present. The other guests have gone back to their rooms by another door.
Thank you.
Ah, Napoleon ist auch noch da. Klar, Frankreich, logisch, Napoleon. Dann Washington, klar, logisch. Ich glaube, ich gehe auch mal aufs Zimmer hoch. Das Turmzimmer wahrscheinlich.
Monsieur Johann van Wulne.
Ah, ich kann jetzt überall rein? Ach, das ist ja nice. Aber versuche George Washington zu überzeugen. Da gehen wir jetzt als erstes hin. Was ist das für ein Raum? Ach so, ja, okay. Dann gehe ich mal ganz schnell wieder raus. Hat ja die eine gewohnt. Wer ist das jetzt? Oh, jetzt bin ich einfach hier irgendwo reingekommen. Ich weiß gar nicht, wem das Haus, wem das hier gehört.
Louis? What are you doing in my room?
Kaka. So tun, als ob du da einen Einbrecher hättest. Falsches Zimmer, Gespräch unter vier Augen. Ja.
I wanted to have a word with you, but just between ourselves. Here, the walls have ears.
You're right. Caution is the mother of safety. Well, since you're here, can I get you something to drink?
No, thank you, Mr. President.
As you wish. Well, Louis, it's getting late, and this is not my first conference. So, let's get straight to the point. You are here to motivate me to change sides.
I hope you're not angry at me. I know that you...
Louis, we are not children. You have your reasons. You will understand that your word no longer holds any value for me. But these things do happen. I only hope you know what you're doing. This is your first conference. And not following the Master of Ceremony who backed you... seems somewhat perilous, but you are young after all. So what can I do for you?
Seine Seite wird verlieren. Lügen. Mortimers Pläne sind gegen ihn gerichtet. Ich mach mal Lügen.
Mr. President, Lord Mortimer treats you purely and simply like the least of his pawns. He gives you no explanation and then commits you to a project from which you have nothing to gain. But you know that more than I do. Is that what siding with Mortimer is all about?
I must confess that I don't entirely understand William lately. Anyway, you haven't really said what you wanted to say. Tell me, Louis, what have you come here to sell me?
You should join home.
And why would I do that?
Gute Frage. Aus Pflicht gegenüber Mutter, er ist es mir schuldig. Er ist bereits mit Emily gegen Frankreich verbündet.
Yet, hearing you speak, anyone would think that your closest ally is France.
Louis, I don't know.
Of course you intend to restore and foster an exchange with England. We both know what that means. It would weaken France's impact on American soil. From there to relinquishing your agreements with France is just one simple step.
You scored a point, Louis. Go on, I'm listening. Tell me what Sir Gregory has to offer that I don't already have with Lord Mortimer.
Er behält, was er bereits hat. Reicht ihm auch Louisiana Versprechen, Interesse des amerikanischen Volkes, Frieden. Warte mal. Erzählen Sie mir, was Sir Gregory anzubieten hat, das Lord Mortimer nicht anbieten kann. Er könnte neue Kolonien erhalten, Interesse des amerikanischen Frieden, ihm auch Louisiana Versprechen, er behält, was er bereits hat, Reichtum. Er könnte neue Kolonien. Ich nehme das.
What would you say to winning a few colonies? I'm sure that Sir Gregory would be prepared to discuss the acquisition of new territories.
No thanks, Louis. I'm not interested. Scheiße. Colonies bring with them their own thorny problems, and thus I prefer to focus on the consolidation of American territory.
Okay, dann würde ich sagen, Frieden? Ihm auch Louisiana versprechen. Oh, das ist jetzt so schwer. Reichtum, ich nehme Frieden.
By following Sir Gregory, you'll be sure to be on the right side of the bayonets, Mr. President. Sir Gregory is encouraging all his partisans to go to war against Lord Mortimer's supporters. Do you really want to go to war again?
Certainly not. I would not allow it. Louis, you convinced me. I congratulate you for your performance, because I didn't think it could happen.
I merely exposed the facts to you.
Don't spoil everything with your false modesty now. You really were very good, and that's that. In any case, I shall follow you on this one. This may well arouse Lord Mortimer's wrath, but I must put the United States before anything else. Have we finished, Louis?
Absolutely, Mr. President. I shan't keep you any longer. Allow me to take my leave.
Good night, Louis. Get some rest. Tomorrow will be a very big day.
Well, that's one thing out of the way. Only thing left to do is wait for the conference to resume tomorrow morning.
Geh ins Bett, okay. Wo ist denn mein Bettchen?
Monseigneur His Eminence Cardinal Piaggi. Huh, that's me.
Ich wusste es.
Good evening, Monsieur le Français.
Duchess, you're here. What a charming surprise. I'm beginning to think you can't be without me.
You have managed to penetrate my armor, sir. Am I disturbing you, perhaps?
Geh ins Bett, Louis. Das ist nicht die richtige Zeit. Auf gar keinen Fall.
That's not what I said.
Ah, by the way, congratulations on choosing Sir Gregory this evening. You surprised me. I wasn't expecting it.
Why, Emily, can't you read me like an open book?
Not as well as you read me, it would seem.
I'll teach you if you'd like.
There's nothing I'd like more.
Tell me, are these visits to Mortimer's always so intense?
Yes and no. My sister doesn't normally disappear like she has. Any news of your mother?
Über Mutter reden?
Well, I should imagine you're still shaken. I promise to shed light on my mother's circumstances as soon as possible.
There's not much to shed light on. What your mother did is inexcusable. She won the trust of my sister in order to more easily betray her. She didn't do anything to her. Can we change subject, please? I didn't come here to go through all that again.
Of course, it's late. You're right.
Ooh! Er hätte ein bisschen Kusssimulation schon gut getan, aber gut, kann ich mitleben. Die Vorstellung ist da.
Komm, Louis.
Und das zweite Mal flachgelegt und ihr schläft immer noch ohne Kissen. Und wir haben schon wieder eine Vision.
Do not worry. I assure you that Lord Mortimer's plan will never see the light of day. I shall deal with informing our allies, but for the time being, I need you to make a stand.
What do you think about Monsieur de Richer?
I don't know yet. I feel there's great potential in him.
He looks like he can be trusted.
Why isn't he with us? He was opposed to Mortimer.
I'll wait and see. I'm still not sure of his position.
And Duchess Hillsborough? Why isn't she here?
She's busy. Don't worry about her.
Oh, isn't it time to replace her?
Not so fast, sir. She is an important figure. You ought to have a little more faith in her.
What are we going to do about Washington?
He will be a hard nut to crack. On our chessboard, he is Mortimer's king.
Don't worry. Mr. President only wants one thing. To keep his dear America united. He won't jeopardize everything he has achieved on a whim.
He has been serving Mortimer for quite some time. It won't be easy to bring him around. I have asked Monsieur de Richet to approach him. Let us have faith in him. I sense that Mr. Peru is about to surprise us too.
Yet he is Mortimer's strong arm in France.
He knows his time has come, and I believe he is intelligent enough to realize it means he is no longer any use to Mortimer. Do you feel all right, Mr. Godoy? You haven't said a word.
Please, excuse me, gentlemen. I feel tired.
Oh, I see. I think it is high time you left us then. Now!
Was? War er tot? Wurde jemand umgebracht?
What?
Ich muss jetzt schon wieder abwarten, Emily? Wann gespeichert wird. Emily ist nie da morgens.
Are you there?
Typical. There she goes again.
Ja, klar.
What's with this habit of hers of taking off in the middle of the night?
Weil sie nicht gesehen werden will, wie sie morgens aus dem Zimmer eines fremden Mannes geht, vielleicht. Ich meine, damals, ne? War das ja noch eine andere Zeit.
Sir, the conference is about to begin. You are expected in the conference room.
Tell them I'm coming. Thank you.
Come on, Louis. The game is back on.
Leider.
My friends, the conference is about to begin. Please excuse me if I troubled you last night with my project. I understand that you might well have a few questions to ask. As you know, the final vote will be cast in a few days. This morning's aim is to answer your questions and check the temperature of your respective positions so that we may reach a greater understanding.
As always, Lord Mortimer.
We parted in perfect disagreement, my lord. Where would you like us to take it from?
Come, sir. Please let William believe he still has a chance of winning us over. Otherwise, his imprecations will lack panache, and we shall be bored stiff.
Oh, let me assure you, I am convinced that a good night's sleep has brought sound advice, and that this morning will be even more interesting. Therefore, I would like to go around the table in order to hear everyone's first impressions.
Well, I am still firmly against it, even though my choice won't count.
Against.
Against. Against.
And you, Luke Manuel?
Against, of course.
Well, as for me, I am for Lord Mortimer's project. Despite Duchess Hillsborough's overwhelmingly convincing nocturnal attentions.
What? So Emily was playing at trying to win over guests last night?
It was nothing more than a friendly little chat, of course.
How could it be otherwise? And by the way, remember me to your husband when you see him. And you, President Washington, what is your position?
Well, you see, Monsieur Bonaparte, I would rather you'd have forgotten me for a minute. William, I am sorry, but I cannot follow you this time.
George? What?
I am against William. Please excuse me. I cannot commit the United States to such an enterprise. It's just too risky.
Well, that leaves just yourself and Monsieur Peru, Louis.
You're all making me sick.
Look at yourselves.
What?
You are pathetic!
Have you been drinking or what?
There you are, quibbling away. My Lord Duke this, and Madame Duchess that. You know very well that we're nothing but puppets on a damn string.
Jacques, Camille.
Let's end the charade. It's over.
Jacques.
My Lord, thank you for everything you've done for me over the years. But it didn't come for free. And now I see the price is too high to pay. I'll stop.
Come, Jacques, we'll talk it over.
No, I'm finished. I want my freedom back, my lord. I shall no longer work for you.
Eingreifen.
Wait!
Derice,
oh,
you
God.
Just can't help it, can you? Stop trying to play the hero, man!
Er verdient das nicht.
Monsieur, I know I don't really know you, but you seem like a decent person.
I have done so many horrible things.
You blame yourself, I can see that. Everything's not lost.
I don't want to do bad things anymore.
You can take control of yourself again. You can fix whatever it is you've done.
Do you really believe that?
Of course, Jacques. You'll have all the time you need.
Es wird alles gut.
I'm sure we can work things out.
But you don't know him.
Let's stay united, Jack. He's nothing without us.
Really?
Trust me.
Ihn um die Waffe bitten. Ihn auffordern, die Waffe zu geben. Ihn um die Waffe bitten.
Come on, Jack. Stop now. Before it gets any worse, give me the gun. Please.
I wasn't gonna fire at anyone, you know.
I know.
Jawohl.
I don't want him to talk to me.
Don't worry, you're safe now, Jack.
Monsieur Peru, you could have seriously hurt someone if Monsieur Drichet here hadn't stopped you. Your behavior is unacceptable. You would do better to go and rest in your apartment. My friends, we shall continue the conference later. I would like to apologize for the inexcusable behavior of my guest. We all need to recover from all of this excitement. Take the rest of the day off.
Hm. Oh. Boah. Okay, das war Episode 3, Kapitel 8, die Konferenz. Erfolgreich. Ich habe George Washington überzeugt. Ich habe Jacques Peru gerettet. Ich habe mit Lady Hillsborough geschlafen. Das ist ein Erfolg. Ich habe mich für Sir Gregory Holmes' Seite entschieden. Ich habe an der Konferenz teilgenommen. Okay, dann wäre noch alternativ gewesen. Ich hätte Jacques Peru Geheimnis lüften können. Ich hätte Lord Mortimer folgen können. Ich hätte ein Geheimnis zu Napoleon Bonaparte lüften können. Das wäre wahrscheinlich, wenn ich da geblieben wäre. Ich hätte mehr über Sir Gregory Holmes herausfinden können. Naja. Okay, dann verteilen wir die Punkte noch eben. Da bin ich dann auf 1, 2. 1, 2.
I don't understand. I spoke to him only recently.
Monsieur Peru has lost his mind. It's obvious.
Yet another way for the French to make a spectacle of themselves. Well, once again, it has worked.
My friends, let us settle down, please. We are all in shock, of course. Let us celebrate Louis' courage. He enabled us to avert a tragedy.
Yes, that was very noble of you, Louis.
You have given us all a fine lesson in courage.
I... thank you.
He owes you his life. That's quite something.
That madman deserves to die.
We are providing Monsieur Peru with care, but rest assured, he is no longer a danger to himself or anyone else. I think everyone needs a little rest. Can you stay a moment?
Of course.
Okay, Bücher lesen noch eben schnell. Ich lese das. Ich lese das und ich lese das. Ja. Ja, so, jetzt beende ich das Spiel und sage Zeug. Tschüss, bis zum nächsten Mal.